Hello everyone, our next concepts are block initializer and final modifier. Now see what is the meaning of the block initializer and how it is used in the program. So what is the definition of the block initializer? Block initializer, it is used to initialize the instance data member. It runs each time when the object of the class is created. Initializer block contains the code that is always executed whenever an instance is created. In other words, we can say that instance initializer block is used to initialize the properties of an object. It is invoked before the constructor is invoked, and it is invoked every time an object is created. Now see, in the program there is a class block initializer is created. In that, the initializer block starts here. Then there is a system println statement is here, and there is a simple messages displayed. And then here this code is executed before every constructor. Here initializer block ends. Then the block initializer constructor is defined here, which takes no parameters. Here the message is displayed by using the println statement. Next, the constructor is defined here, which takes the parameters. So message is displayed here by using the println statement here. Then in the main method, the objects of the class block initializer are created, that are obj1 and obj2. Now see here in the statement, block initializer obj1 is equal to new block initializer. In this statement or in this sentence, when the obj1 is created, then automatically the block initializer is invoked first every time, and after that the constructor is invoked. When same here for the statement block initializer obj2 is equal to new block initializer, here when obj2 is created, then automatically first the block initializer is executed first, and after that the constructor which takes the parameter is executed. Understood? Then see here what will be the output of this program here. Then the output window you can see here. Inside instance initializer block statement is executed, which is a block initializer statement. After that the constructor invoked a statement is here, which is a defined in the block initializer constructor, which takes no parameters. Same here, second time inside instance initializer block statement is displayed here, which is executed or which is invoked first after the before the constructor is invoked, and after that the parameterized constructor invoked statement is executed. Understood? Okay. Then see, our next program is based on the final keyword. The final keyword in Java is used to restrict the user. The Java final keyword can be used in many variables, in many contexts. Then final can be a variable, final can be a method, and final can be a class. So let's see these context, or see these three types one by one. Okay, the first type is the Java final variable, means we have created here the variable that uses the final modifier. See here in the program, there is a class var final. In that, we have declared here the integer variable p, whose access modifier is the final. So this is the p is the final variable, and the value is assigned to the p is, it is the 90. So once we have declared one variable, then it is acting like a constant variable. Then in the there is a run method is defined here. In that, we again assign the value p is equal to 400. Then after that, this value is printed by using the println statement here. And in the main method, the object of the var final is created, and by using this object the run method is called here. So after running this file, when you run this program, then you can see there is a compile time error is there. Because why this is happen? Because once we assign a variable to the value, then we cannot change that value. once it is assigned, it is constant. We can't change that value to another value. So there is a variable. So there is a compile time error is you cannot assign a value to the final variable p. You can see here. Then next, when you run this file, then there will be a compile time error. See this. These are the errors. So when for checking or for for checking, you can remove this final keyword here. And then after that, you can see the output. What will be the output of this file? So see here, the statement is executed and value is displayed as 400, which is assigned in here. Understood? This is the variable which is declared as a final. Next, our next use of the final is the method. When we declare the method as a final, then we cannot override that method. Okay, when we try to override that method, then there will be a compile time error. See how it will happen. So there is a class method final, and in that there is a show method is defined here, which is declared as final, and in that simple message is displayed here. Then there is a sample class which extends the method final class. So this is a sample class is the subclass and method final is the superclass. Then there is a method show here, overriding of the overriding method show. But there is an error is displayed here. That is, show in a sample cannot override show in method final, because overridden method is final. So now understood, you can see here the message. Once you declared a method as a final, you cannot override that method. So there is a simple println statement which displays the message, and there is a main method. In that main method, the sample subclass object S1 is created, and by using that S1, you can call the show method. After running this file, you can see there is a compile time error, because you are trying to override the method show which is declared as a final. So see here, there is a errors are there, because you are trying to override the method final as. So when you remove this final keyword, then it will show the output window. Sorry, it will show the output of this program. Hello Java. Understood? Next, the next use of the final method, final keyword is when you declare a final class as a final, then you cannot inherit that class or you cannot extend that class. See here how it will happen. Final class, there is a class test which is declared as a final, and then class final is, this is the class which extends the test. Means the class final trying to extend the test class which is declared as already final. So when you run this program, then there will be error, because we are trying or we are breaking the rules of the final, because once you declared a class as a final, you cannot inherit that class. So see here, there is a message is displayed here, cannot inherit from final test, because this class test is the final. Then there is a show method, and there is a printl statement which is testing final message displayed. Then in the main method, the object of the class final is created, and by using the object, the show method is called here. But after running this program, you can see here the errors are there. To remove this error, you have to remove the final keyword. Now see the output. Testing final message is displayed.